My name is Gerd Leonhard, and I am a futurist. Let me start by saying that the future is not what it used to be. There have been many times in human history when the future seemed utterly uncertain or, of course, dark and dystopian. But there has rarely been a time when so many people around the world questioned the future in such a fundamental way as they do today. The Danish philosopher Søren Kierkegaard once said that life must be lived forwards, but can only be understood backwards. Well, that may have been true in 1845, but nowadays I think we must learn how to remember the future, to travel forward 7 to 10 years, and to then return with what we've learned in order to make a better decision today. Hence, I humbly present this film, taking us forward to 2030 twice, the dark and lousy future and the more heavenly one. But you may ask, what's the point of even envisioning a good future when the present is already such a hopeless mess? Well, I think it matters a lot how we think about the future, because as we see the future, so we act, and as we act, so we become. In the words of American futurist Barbara Hubbard. Indeed, I believe that our attitude contains our future. So, let's take a look, starting with a dark version of 2030. Right now, in 2030, you don't have to be a pessimist to think that human nature is still not very evolved or that humans are simply not good. After this protracted war, which began in the early 20s, we now find ourselves hammered by war-induced traumas and excessive military spending. At the same time, we are living with the ongoing threat of a nuclear incident, witnessing the collapse of our global world order that had secured a fragile peace for over 70 years, and a planet that's nearing environmental shutdown. People are scared and seriously worried about the future, especially the young generations. Depression and mental illness are rampant. Suicide rates are on the rise, and for the first time since World War II, life expectancy is declining in many countries. The internet, once the world's most promising platform for communication and collaboration, is awash with garbage, noise, and cheap speech. Fake everything, not just news and media, but actual people too. Identity theft, virtual reality escapism, and cryptocurrency Ponzi schemes hardly a turn towards enlightenment of the much-promised new creator economy. Mass migration has become rampant because life is so desperate in countries that are ruled by autocrats. Many nations are facing a deeply polarized populace. An increasing number of democratic nations are stuck in a rigged game of vested interests, and politics is becoming a farce. The idea of a United States of Europe has been squashed by petty quarreling and a return to isolationist policy making. We look back with nostalgia on the great vanished leaders of the past like extinct heroes. The scorching summers that have seared themselves into public memory since the early 20s have now become so common that we take them for granted. And during the hottest days, we won't even go outside unless we can bring our portable AC units. Clean energy is still the top story, but that's all that remains, a narrative. The collective blah 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 still vastly outdoes meaningful action. As the war has siphoned off both attention and money, we are more heavily reliant on fossil fuels than ever before. Even coal has made a major comeback. Tensions and rivalries between the North and the South are increasingly pulling the world in two directions. The North wants southern nations to stop polluting. The South wants the North to pay for that and to practice what it preaches. Growth still takes precedent over purpose, and the richest companies in the world are once again those that are destroying it. Yes, the planet in 2030 is a lot like the one in 2022, only increasingly uglier, hotter, and nastier. The once hopeful vistas of so-called digital transformation have been carved up into walled gardens and digital fiefdoms. A brutal downward cycle of technological unemployment, inequality, and class conflicts is accelerating. Ordinary people are becoming digital sharecroppers, working in the cloud or in one of the vast global metaverses. The potentially most liberating tools in human history, smart machines and artificial intelligence, have instead evolved into the most comprehensive surveillance machine of all time. That's a quick look at the world in 2030. Merely a slight exaggeration of our present-day reality, and it's certainly not what I would call the good future. Okay, now let's take a breather. You know, sometimes people talk about the future as if it was a blank screen to imagine absolutely anything on. But that's not the way the future works. The future is a mindset more than it is a time frame. And our mindsets are usually self-fulfilling prophecies. Like I said, as we see the future, so we act. And as we act, so we become. But thankfully, 2030 also has another potential. So let's explore this more beautiful and positive alternative. It is 2030 and things are looking up. Instead of a turn towards climate Armageddon and techno-tyranny, we took the road towards the good future, towards more holistic and sustainable economics and global collaboration on the issues that matter most for our survival, such as energy, food, water, and health. Awareness, resilience, ingenuity, and innovation are the order of the day. Supercomputing, fast global connectivity such as 7G, augmented reality, open virtual work platforms, and machine intelligence governed by ethics have together unlocked an Aladdin's cave of possibilities. An increasing number of people from all walks of life around the globe are involved in profitable economic activity. And we are witnessing a renaissance of human-only occupations, such as counseling, teaching, and caretaking. Tens of millions of new jobs have been created as a result of the sustainability revolution. All layers of business and industry, from utilities and banks to manufacturers and technology, are becoming connected ecosystems of services and experiences, transforming our lives. Human agency, ingenuity, imagination, and creativity are more important than ever before. Our algorithms have empowered, not enslaved us, and humans are being kept firmly in the loop everywhere. Humanity first is the leading paradigm of technology. Ethics and AI have dovetailed to underpin a new economic logic that is respectful of human limitations, transparent, equitable, and balanced. As technology is being tempered with purpose, ethics, and values, we are witnessing the reboot of social media as a human rather than a data-centric business. Algorithms are everywhere, but they no longer mindlessly run the show. Humans are back in the loop, and consciousness is starting to beat convenience. Humans in 2030 are empowered by technology, not threatened or substituted by it. After peace returned to Europe in 2023, the tough lessons we learned from that crisis fueled a rebirth of geopolitics and global collaboration across the board in civil society, trade, science, and technology. At the same time, a rejuvenation of democracy is driving big changes in policy making. A global ministry for the future has been established in Zurich, Switzerland, and it is now starting to influence many key decisions on humanity's future. Our planetary resources are no longer taken for granted. Strong and binding international agreements have forced nations to act on climate change, swiftly and jointly. Kim Stanley Robinson's 2020 carbon coin idea is becoming a reality. Those that have polluted in the past are now paying those that haven't yet, paying them not to do the same, to leave the carbon in the ground. Global temperature increases have been slowed down and carbon emissions have been dramatically slashed. Nobody can afford to be a pariah in this new world. Investing in fossil fuels is now akin to a criminal activity. The green economy has taken off, and that old synchronicity between profit and planetary destruction is history. Finally, it costs less and pays more to think and act green. Green is not only the new digital, but sustainable is quickly becoming the new profitable as stock markets around the world move towards long-term thinking and the four P's: people, planet, purpose, and prosperity. 30% of all land will soon be reserved for nature, and rewilding our world is on top of the agenda. E.O. Wilson would have loved it. Nuclear fusion is evolving leaps and bounds, promising energy abundance within a decade, and jump-starting our space exploration plans. We will indeed become a multi-planet species before the end of the century. The food and agriculture revolution is in full swing as we explore new possibilities of feeding 9 billion people. Cultured meat, organic farming, both in vertical systems as well as in the fields, and the global rise of vegetarianism are promising to solve our food shortages while helping to heal the planet. Electric vehicles and shared mobility have done much to reduce global pollution, and traffic jams in overcrowded cities are soon to be a thing of the past. Gasoline thinking has been replaced by ecosystem innovation. Battery technologies have leaped, lithium is an old hat, and cars can travel 1,000 miles on a single charge. Work has become hybrid in all of its variations, with many new jobs in the cloud, as well as lots of new jobs on the ground, for example, in climate change adaptation and mitigation. The culture wars of the early 20s have been replaced by the new Belle Epoque, a strange kind of golden age where the old is clearly no longer feasible and the new swiftly fills the void. Human lives are improved and extended by many new healthcare solutions, such as digital therapeutics and AI-assisted drug discovery. While costs are dramatically declining, free medical care for everyone is coming within reach. Education has finally gone beyond downloading information and storing outdated knowledge for later use, towards imagination and creativity, consciousness and human-only skills. Sustainable airline fuel and hydrogen is taken over from kerosene, and in Europe, high-speed trains are dominating long-distance travel. While around the world, many of us connect in virtual environments instead of jetting off to a brief meeting. Tourism has been rebooted to be completely circular, and long-standing aberrations such as cruise ships are disappearing in the rearview mirror, along with their smokestacks. The so-called developing countries are taking the lead in a global reboot of what good tourism actually means. Yes, the 2030 planet is becoming cleaner and healthier. As we recalibrate the way we work, live, eat, move around, and sustain ourselves, the planet heaves a sigh of relief. A new awareness and budding global consciousness is tangible, especially among Gen Y and Z. Our planet is not healed yet, but it is healing. A fantasy, a possibility, or a potential? The past happened once upon a time, but as you can clearly see, the future may happen twice upon a time. Whichever way you look at it, your attitude will define your future, and the choices you make today will create your future. Let me know one way or the other whether you believe in the good future or the lousy future. Thanks for watching, and see you in the future.